you have a money? I have a magic. The very own real magic. But only for real money.
Here. Your family stole it. I'm here to take it back. We don't want to make this any more unpleasant than it already is. Time I told him would. Unwrap it, Grimaldi. They always said they were magic. Show me the magic.
How well do you read the language of your ancestors?
Henry?
Come here.
Eureka.
So you have told me what, but you have yet to tell me why.
You and I both know this is a time of change.
Granted.
And Caesar has stolen what little peace we enjoyed.
The protection of an army of occupation is hardly something we'll enjoy.
So much of what I have achieved is at stake. It's just not safe anymore. I've spent most of my adult life leading the one tribe in this country that has given our Roman visitors something to worry about.
And we've done well.
We've done too well. I foresee a time of conflict. Local squabbles are a thing of the past. We now have one common enemy, and that makes us vulnerable.
Vulnerable?
Yes. This tribe is the richest on all our islands. And maybe those who tried to profit from this time of advantage.
I'm thinking of
those who come after me. What will I have to leave behind for them?
Back to where we started with the what, but you have yet to tell me why you require my help.
This is our strongest time. Blink once and it will be gone. I need its magic preserving. I need your magic.
You mean
I mean a charm or a curse. I mean for the great secret of our Bergantian tribe to be frozen for all time. I want the people still to come to realize our might. And above all...
Yes?
I want to live forever.
Quattro.
Miliardi e mezzo.
Quattro.
Solve. A lot 32.
Now that's the one that I've been waiting for.
Surrealist painting, possibly over the Ashley School.
I figured I could hang it in my washroom.
Shall we start a bidding at 5,800 lire?
I'm up for that.
5,900.
It might be a bit too big, huh? But hell, we could cut a couple of inches off it. Hey, Monsieur, I'll put another $1,000 on that, or lire's, whatever.
We're going at once, eh? We're going at twice, eh? Sold it to the American gentleman with it he had for 5,900 lire.
Yes, sir!
So what do you think, guys? The bathroom or the water closet?
You are a proud woman, Katie Mandor. You and your husband have done much for us. You shall have your curse. Visit me in 3 days. Bring Venutius with you. Be careful. There are those who would try to betray us. Keep on your guard.
Mamma, what is wrong?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? You are a mother, the leader of our family. We know when something is wrong.
Ah, si. This family.
What is wrong with our family?
For centuries, this family has traded our Turks here in Venice. We have made money out of the insane, selfish desire of the people to possess art. And for centuries, we fed their passion with fakes and imitation.
Yeah, but we have become very rich, no?
Maybe, yes.
Ah, but you think in some ways no, eh?
Cesare, Gennaro, my son. I had been head of this family since the death of my dear Aldo. And I don't want to die knowing that our time here has been as fake as the things we auction. Read this.
What is this, huh? Mama, what is that, huh?
That, my son, is our birthright. That is more real than the most realistic figure we ever produce. That is the only thing that give me hope. This is the bill of the sale, which sold this ancient magical press stone to a passing English trader.
That's no problem to make a copy.
Oh!
Yeah, what is so special about this, huh?
Magic.
Magic, mamma, come on, huh?
Magic? What a kind of a magic.
Cesare, my son! The fortune of this family was made from forgery. Very clever, very sophisticated forgery. You too, your gentlemen criminals. This jewel is the only our connection with success.
That is old.
And you are young. This jewel is the only key to a treasure. And is more precious than anything under your hammer. I want it back! I want you two to get it back. You owe it to our family. Bring it back. Home.
Brigantis, can we fly direct, huh?
About it. It's definitely the richest find in the north of England. Who knows when there'll be another artifact like it.
Get in now. Make sure you lock up the main door, Mr. Henry. You know, sometimes you forget.
Don't worry. It's got me to remind him tonight.
Lucky for us all, yeah? Good night now.
Night. Aren't you even a little bit curious?
About what?
Well, about the people who made it.
It says here, the name Brigantia represents three separate concepts. A goddess, a people, and a tribal federation. But they were probably ordinary people, much like you and me.
Yeah, well, that's just it, isn't it? If they were ordinary people like you and me, then they'd have a story to tell, like we do.
What story is that then?
Well, they lived like we do, and they loved like we do. Don't we?
Sorry?
Well, didn't they have thoughts and feelings as well as artifacts?
I suppose so.
So don't be so quick to put them into a category then. Oh, come on. You've done enough for tonight. Let's go and get a life.
So who are these Brigantes?
Such a me. Thieves, perhaps.
Hey, someone is a coming.
Say nothing.
Si, si.
Let me do the talking.
Okay, si, si.
Hey, mamma mia!
Hey, baby!
Hey, excuse me!
So who is it then, eh?
He's the one with the jewel.
Yeah.
But I'm the one with the key.
It won't all fall apart if you stop watching over it, you know.
I have to be vigilant.
We all do. There are times when you've just got to be you.
Not sure if I know what me is anymore. It's as if I've become an expectation rather than a human being. Someone people turn to when they need dragging out of the mire.
Seems to work.
We all have limits, I'm human too. Madame. This time, I've met my match. That's all.
You won't talk. I can't help.
You can't help anymore.
Horse is ready. You've done well with my help. Never forget. Can't do much without it.
I can find my own help. You! Your name?
Me?
Yes, you.
Velocatus.
And what job do you do for him?
Armor bearer.
What else do you do?
What do you mean?
Visit me tonight.
Good evening. And as thieves ransack the opening of an exhibition, we have a report on the mysterious theft of the region's most important archaeological discovery. Also
on northwestern... Still don't understand how it could just vanish.
It's been stolen, Henry.
Yeah. What's the fascination with a lump of old stone? Why can't they just leave our heritage alone?
You really don't have any idea, do you?
Well, I can't see how a mucky old stone could motivate somebody to break into a museum and steal it. Just it, on its own. Didn't take out else. They must have known what they were coming for.
Be quiet, he's on.
Mourning the loss of the most important discovery relating to its distant past. Glynis Stewart reports from the opening of the exhibition that stayed closed.
It was set to be the event of the century, the missing link in the history of Northern England, unearthed by unsuspecting local girl. Helena Matthews' discovery was set to be the centrepiece of the exhibition about our Brigantian heritage. But plans for the grand opening were scotched last night by thieves who mysteriously removed the jewel from its place in the museum.
Well, obviously it was a great thrill to discover such an important piece of our history. We don't know too much about it, but we do think the ancient Britons called it the Bloodstone. Well, I've no idea
why... I've been blowed!
Appealing for any information that may lead to the recovery of this very important ancient artifact.
Granddad, how are they making a film of your book?
It's not often you make a groundbreaking archaeological discovery and then in your moment of glory have it snatched away from you.
I know. So much for the magic of the silver screen, eh?
If only we had a clue. Some idea of who they are. Hello? And what they want it for? Yeah, this is Henry. I mean, it's not as if... What? He said... And a what? I'll be right there. How are you with curses?
No!
We'll not give in.
The battle's fought and lost.
The battle's only just beginning.
Just don't understand, do you?
I understand that magic won't win battles.
Unlike you, I believe there's something worth saving. Unlike you, I know to see alternatives rather than brute force.
You only want to save yourself. History only remembers warriors and failures, you know. Which one are you?
Professor Peake, good to meet you.
And you, my boy.
This is Eleanor.
God, the fair maid who unearthed our little treasure. Come in. Such a pity you've mislaid our little wonder so soon after having found her.
I know, it wasn't intentional, though.
Oh, quite so. Oh, but I see you've not been neglecting your research.
No, but I've not had time to finish it yet.
No matter. It's been a while, and to tell you the truth, I've changed my mind about a lot of what I wrote about.
Professor, Henry says there's a curse on the jewel. It's not true, is it?
Oh, it's mostly folklore, of course. The ancient Britons weren't terribly good about writing down things for us to reconstruct into their history.
A curse, Professor, yes or no?
Yes, yes. You see, it all appears to date back to the time of Queen Cartimandua. She was a powerful lady. She probably had much in common with young Eleanor here.
Am I right in thinking that it dates back as early as the Roman occupation?
Oh, further, further. Along the side of the stone, there's an inscription in a language that we're only just now beginning to decipher.
Language?
Yes, they, my dear. Along the side of the stone, you see those sharp incisions? That's Ogham, that is.
Ogham?
Yes. Oh, Ogham. The symbolic language of the early Celts.
Precisely.
But you say in this book that it can't be read.
Correction, couldn't be read. But since I wrote that, things have changed a bit.
So what does it mean?
Well, I think it says that this is the Brigantian treasure key. Accursed be all thieves and invaders.
A treasure key?
Yes, I think so.
What kind of treasure?
Oh, there you have me, my boy. It's a very dark period in our history, one that we know very little about.
So it could be a fake?
No, it could be. But Cartimandua was the queen of Brigantia, ancient Yorkshire, not far from where we're sitting. That was during the time of the Roman invasion of Britain. She was as close as they got to a hot potato, I'm sure.
Oh, come on, Professor, you're teasing us. You know more than you're letting on.
Well, we don't know much about her, but she's most famous for capturing and handing over the leader of a rival British tribe to the Roman army. Now, you're not telling me that she wasn't rewarded handsomely for that little manoeuvre.
So you mean there's still treasure for us to find?
Maybe so. We do know that Queen Cartimandua had quite a hang-up about things magical.
Or it may be that the curse will fall on us. Oh, come on, Professor. You can't expect us to believe all this rubbish. It's just a few words inscribed on the side of an ancient jewel, in a language which no one can understand anymore. Let's face the facts. Our centrepiece has been stolen. I suppose you'll be telling us next that the curse will bring it back.
You may not be far wrong there, my boy.
Have you ever wondered about your name?
My name?
Yeah. Such a musical name, Cartimandua. Sounds beautiful to me.
You say the sweetest things.
Oh, I'm serious. In fact, I'm so serious, I even went and asked Iltyd what our queen's name actually means.
It's what?
Don't laugh, it's interesting.
So, tell me then, wise one.
Well, he said that it means you have a good business mind and that people can rely on you to make decisions. And when you give your word, you'll do your utmost to fulfill the responsibility.
And what else?
Well...
Yes?
He said that family and close bonds of friendship are really important to you.
Well, that's true enough.
But you experience worry by assuming more responsibility than you should.
Probably more to this names game than meets the eye.
You mean Venusius?
Yes. And I'm only trying to help him, but he thinks I'm interfering with his rights. Great friction between us. But then I've got you to take my friction out on.
You're worried, aren't you?
Is it that obvious? It's the end of everything I've worked for. Everything the British tribes have aimed for.
Seems a pity.
And we can't fight it. It's inevitable. If only there was some way we could keep them out of the country, we'd have a chance.
Iltyd said there was magic. He said that our only chance was to try and use his skill.
It's probably the only sure way that the women who come after me stand a fighting chance. But in the meantime...
Yeah. Doesn't look very magical to me.
Appearances can be deceptive. They should make you much money, no?
What's it mean, then?
Search me. Just a lot of scratches and marks. Let's have a look.
There's no I can make out.
No. Let me see now. It almost looks like it could be incomplete.
Incomplete? Here, you told me to tell me the stone and the magic. You trying to pull the wool over my
Surely
eyes?
Surely not. You don't trust me. Here, look. You see before you a man who's desperate. I have great loans and debts to repay.
No, I know it.
I would never cheat such a fellow trader such as yourself. Besides, I have very much to lose. You are my route to the English. They'll pay me many more ducats for some of our Italian magical stones, no?
That's as maybe. But this is a special case. I've got someone back in England who wants this special light. But it's got to be the right one.
Besides, what use would I have for any bits that were left over?
I bid you farewell, Signor Grimaldi.
Okay, so our job is done and now we go home, yeah?
Yes. No. We stay here. We go nowhere. We don't move.
You are very cruel, eh? For telling me. We are a great success as partners, eh, no?
So far, so good. But we're not finished yet.
The Bloodstone, an ancient jewel stolen from a regional exhibition. You'll no doubt be fascinated to know that the jewel is likely to remain within our shores. Professor John Peake, an expert in the history of the period, today revealed that an inscription on the artifact itself may cause a mortal curse to descend upon the thief who wittingly or unwittingly removes it from our shores. And if that isn't poetic justice, I don't know what is.
Dio mio.
It looks like we may be here longer than I think.
Now is the time for the charm to be engendered.
Chosen ones, join me in a celebration.
The thing is, Lucretia, I didn't think it was going to be this big. I was going to put it in the water closet, but I think it might interfere with the flushing system.
Mr. Walburn.
Hey, you can call me Buster.
Mr. Walburn, Grimaldi's is fine art auction house, not a lending library.
Sure, but you got to understand the problem. It's Mrs. Wahlberg. She's very particular about the decor. She'll think it's too big.
Pronto?
Hey, Mama.
Cesare, my son.
Mama, have you heard the news?
Sì, sì. La maledizione. You must both stay put. Stay put. I don't want you or your brother to be cursed.
Hey. No offense, Lucretia, but I gotta consider my plumbing problem.
I'm not interested in your water supply.
We are having the water problems of our own.
Just stay put. I join you tomorrow. I catch the plane.
Hey, bring your umbrellone, eh?
Umbrellone?
And leave the water behind you in Venezia, eh?
The water?
Hey, Mama! Mama! Mama!
Ah, stupid thing. Come on.
Gee, you Italians certainly drive a hard bargain. Does your alteration service take traveler's checks?
So now we go home, see?
We go nowhere. A mama comes here.
Here?
Here, tomorrow. I think she has a deep plan.
I don't care if she has a 20 plans.
Hey, we must just be patient, eh? Tomorrow we know.
Okay.
If there is treasure, what do you reckon it'll be?
I don't know. I'm not really sure what an ancient warrior battle queen would have considered valuable.
Oh, come off it. You've dug up more bits of ancient tat than anyone. You know what's valuable and what's not.
Yeah, but it's different this time. I mean, I'm fine digging bits and pieces of our past out of the earth, but I've never dealt with magic and curses before.
What reminds us, are we talking jewels and crowns?
You don't change you, do you?
Some people are destined to be romantic dreamers all their life. Check our queen.
Battle leader.
Oh, whatever. Look. You said yourself the facts are vague, so why not imagine the personalities behind your precious facts?
What? Are you saying that your queen might have been a dreamer too?
I'll make a human being out of you yet.
Well, dreamers don't believe in curses.
Maybe. But the professor didn't understand exactly what kind of curse it was.
Yeah, true. Clever idea of his.
What?
Well, they're no export rule.
Perhaps. It hasn't made our search any easier just yet, has it?
Look, there are two rules to being an archaeologist. One, everything comes to those who wait.
And rule two.
Well, don't be tempted to become a romantic dreamer.
Oh, so you are tempted then.
So, now that you have your precious stone, and you can take it back to where it rightfully belongs.
I hope for your sake you're not trying to pull a fast one.
Hey, honesty is my middle name. You can rely on me.
Listen, I hope so. For your sake.
You're my friend, no? We have much business still to do with each other. My children, my family, we are very much in your debt, no? Huh? He wanted the magic. You get what he deserves.
Okay, you weren't to know. I wasn't to know, none of us were to know. Ho ben compreso. Basta!
The problem is, now? What have we do now?
Yeah, it's a sign. We should go home.
Go home? Gennaro, you speak like a true Grimaldi. Go home. We just arrived from Italy and you think that we should go home. Ha!
So you have a plan, eh?
Of course that I have a plan.
Yeah, but see, but what about the curse?
Basta! You boys are afraid of a centuries-old curse. It takes your mama, Lucrezia Grimaldi, to save our honor.
Hey, when we come here, you tell us nothing about a curse.
I know nothing of any curse. I know nothing of an inscription. But I do know about this.
What is that?
That, my son, is their missing link. Come now. We must enter the pursuit of your beautiful young lady.
We got it.
Did we?
It's here in this pack. Magic and all.
Well, I didn't see any magic. Did you, really?
You don't think it's real, do you?
You know, it's real enough. But you know that double-crossing slimeball. You know, he's just sold as one of the Venetian state's most treasured possessions. And sign for it.
It has to be real, then, doesn't it?
Senor. Senor. Senor.
You know, I don't know if we've been sold up or not, but I was sure fire we'll find it out.
I never thought he could do it.
Do it? Do what?
Do exactly as I asked. Take from me all that I've done and wrap it up into something so beautiful.
What is it that you're so desperate to prove?
Prove? Nothing. Nothing at all. That bit's already done. What I want people to do is remember. Remember our strength and power. Remember me.
And that's why you arranged that elaborate ritual with Iltyd?
Partly. I want to make sure everyone knows who's in charge here.
That sounds as though it was aimed at me.
Oh, no. Not you. You're a very pleasant diversion. Very pleasant.
Who then? Venusius?
You ask too many questions.
Thought so.
There's nothing left to prove to him. It's over.
Not in the eyes of the rest of the tribe.
Well, what they won't see won't hurt them.
Do you really believe that he can do it? Magic?
Yes. Certain of it.
You know, with the stone being magical and all that, you think there's something we could do to evoke the magic and bring it back again, wouldn't you?
Rubbish.
Suit yourself. Some of us prefer to believe in the power of history.
Look, if you're really going to believe in all this magic rubbish, why don't you visit the professor? Perhaps he could hold a seance. And you could get in touch with your tribal ancestors.
There's no need to get shirty, is there?
Perhaps you're right, Mr. Henry. Perhaps it is all claptrap. But folk need something to believe in. Anyway, magical or not, there's an air of confusion surrounding your precious stone. You'd do well to explore all your angles. Bid you good night.
Good night. Thank you.
Use.
Where are you going?
It don't take two of us to cry over spilt milk, does it?
Look, I don't know if there's magic in the stone or not, but I'm going to take it at your word. I will contact our ancestors and I will find out.
Rubbish.
Eleanor, my dear, come in, come in.
Professor, I hope you don't mind me calling like this. It's just...
Not at all, not at all. Come in, come in.
Thank you. I wanted to talk to you about the curse.
Now, you're curious why our ancient queen should be so protective about her stone.
I think we are all curious about the motive of your ancient queen. It is time that we have a little chat.
Who's there?
It's all right. I'm unarmed. I know our number's up. You have won. I have something to trade. Something valuable. Magic. A magical stone. Very special to the queen of my tribe. I said I wanted to trade.
Speak on, Britain.
I need safety. Protection. I can give you information. Inside information.
Magic, you say?
Magic. And a curse.
You see, Professor, I'm a reasonable woman. I'm not someone who harbors grudges, but my family has been the guardians of this precious jewel for many centuries. So when it comes to any treasure, surely it must belong to us.
Well, how do you explain me digging it up out of the ground, then?
Because, as you English say, we don't have the full pictures.
The piece of the jewel which unearthed last week is only part...
A part? That jewel was first drawn in the 15th century.
Yes, I know. When my ancestor Annibal sold it to Leofric, and it made its way back here and was lost until you dug it up.
But I still don't understand. You've got your jewel now. What do you want with us?
What I want is your brain, Professor. And this young lady has provided us with the route to it, you see. For the first time, our peace interlocks with yours. And for the first time since my ancestors sold it in the 15th century, they are united. Now the message can be read complete. We need your gift, Professor.
Well, I can't be absolutely sure of mine, but I think it says that this is the Brigantine treasure key, accursed be all thieves and invaders who are not women.
That's all?
That's all. How wonderfully curious. It's as if it's been waiting all these years to be discovered.
Wonderful? Perhaps, Professor. But a more interesting discovery in its ancient secrets.
You say the stone is a magic, huh? But do you really believe that this is true, huh?
It's not for me to say.
Yeah, but you can make the stone perform the magic tricks, no?
Magic, my boy! It's a thing for circuses! If that's all you're interested in, you may as well just take your family back to Italy and leave us in peace. Yes.
Look, you think you're clever, don't you? With your book and your brains. Well, I get this. I don't care about how much you know. My brother and I, we travel all the way from Italia. We found your stone. We nearly get accursed. What a more is there to endure in this stupid country? You had better start talking, Professor. You had better start talking soon, because I have had enough of this stupid country. You understand, eh?
Cesare, pace. Professor, let us talk like adults. We own half of the secret that you can help us reveal. Tell us what you can, then we can bring this business to an end.
Where's my book? See the similarity. I can't think why I didn't notice it before.
Because you're an imbecile.
Cesare, basta. Do you know where this cave is located?
Of course. The cave has long been known as a place sacred to the Brigantes.
Hey, baby. You fancy a date with the cursed Italiano, huh? Yeah?
Yeah, he said it was genuine.
No, it's not possible.
It's as genuine as hand in front of your face.
And you acquired this here?
Aye, from Grimaldi. That slimeball. You know him?
Aye.
He implied it was magic. Said to make me a rich man. He implied it, like.
What kind of magic?
Search me.
Well, if what you say is true, then it is a crime against the Venetian state. The matter will be investigated by the Council of Ten. I will convey your plane to the Doge, personally.
No!
It's time to make amends. Simple. Your king, or you're a traitor. You choose.
Ever there when you want them. Something I've said.
This isn't the ending I'd hoped for.
No.
It's not what we fought for, together.
We lost that a long time ago.
Yeah, maybe.
Where will you go?
Back north, I suppose. Why did you have to spoil it?
Because we're different people, Venutia. We always were.
Yeah.
The stone was just another indication of how different we are. Go, please. Go quickly.
Magic. That stone will be the downfall of any man who comes near it. Goodbye, Cartamandra. You got what you wanted.
You must to take us tomorrow. Oh my God.
This is the police. This is the police! This is the police!
Police! We leave, pronto!
Hey, we leave it through the back way, eh?
We go now!
Hammer! Hammer! Give yourselves up!
Gennaro, presto, presto! Gennaro, presto!
Hey, it's your loss, baby,
Annibale Grimaldi, you stand convicted of forgery and profiting from the sale thereof. This is a crime against the Venetian state and one which carries with it a severe penalty. Do you have anything to say in your defense before the Doge passes sentence? Signor Grimaldi, have you nothing to say?
It is not true. I sold to him the genuine stone. It is not
I,
true.
Francesco Frescari, Doge of Venice. Find you, Annibale Grimaldi, guilty of crimes against the Venetian state. I have sentenced you to serve a term of indeterminate length in the prisons of the Venetian state. May God have mercy on your soul. Release shall be granted. At our pleasure.
Take him away.
This is it, no?
Such themes.
So, what happens now?
Now we try the magic of the stone.
Like I said before, magic is for circuses, my boy.
Hey, careful, signore. I think you open your mouth too wide one day, eh?
I'm prepared to risk that.
Hey, perhaps I'll risk my fist on your nose,
hey,
eh?
Buster, come on, we try the magic, huh?
Well, it's now or never, I suppose.
down to the cave. Henry, wake up, Henry. Come on. Come on, wake up. We've got to go.
Now is the time to taste the magic of the stone.
Ah, it's about the time too, huh?
Silencio!
Excuse me?
Hey, you heard it, the lady, eh? Silencio.
Not yourselves. That your family name by any chance doesn't happen to be Grimaldi, does it?
How do you know that? How can you know that?
Pace, pace, eh? We tried the magic, huh? Mamma, come on, huh? Arrivederci tutti. See you in the next world.
Easy memento, senor. And no passing in things through the bars.
I'm sorry.
What have you to be sorry for?
I didn't realise. Back in England, they just flog you. Put you in the stocks or something. Not this.
Here my life will end. I have you to thank for that. They say that a condemned man has the power to change the course of history.
They don't say that, do they?
The stone I sold to you in a good of faith was made for a woman long ago to protect her from the men around who tried to take away her power. They took away a stone, her bloodstone.
Look, I got that for a fella back in Yorkshire.
She knew it. So she put a curse on it. A curse on all. Not on of her sex or of her bloodline. And as a condemned man, I have the power to invoke that curse. And that is what I'm gonna do.
Finito, senor.
I'm going home. I just wanted you to know, I never wanted it to end like this.
Only when it has claimed a life, will its power be weakened. Now, my curse upon you and on all the guardians of the stone. Remember the stone's power. It must only be passed to the direct descendants. It must be fed with the lives of others.
You see, my boy, the answer lies in the inscription on the second stone. Who are not women of our bloodline. Quite a conundrum in itself, but it was only when I saw the second stone that it clicked.
So, where are they now?
Who knows? Who cares, my boy? A curse on all thieves and invaders.
So, are they dead then?
Well, after the events of the past few days, I'm wondering whether any of us are really alive. You read my book? With a fellow in Venice in the 15th century. He was called Grimaldi too, and he predicted that the stone must be fed with human life. Looks like his descendants just got their inheritance. Over to you, my dear. You have the mark of history on you.
I've been waiting for you for a long time. Ah, I see you've brought back my stone at last.
Who are you?
I'm your ancestor, my dear. I've been waiting so long to meet you.
No, this isn't happening.
Oh, it really is. You've come to set me free. This lump of ancient rock has got me into awful trouble.
Trouble?
Mm. Just as it has affected others, so it has its effect on my existence too.
Look, I've got absolutely no idea what I'm doing here.
You're here because it's your destiny. Like me, you were marked out from birth to carry out this task. You couldn't have avoided it even if you wanted to. None of us could. It was the mark of our bloodline.
I don't get it. Where exactly am I?
There's no need to worry. We're everywhere and nowhere. We're standing in the focal point of time itself. So you can confirm the magic which I had locked into this stone. Here. Take this staff back to your world. Take the stone too. Its work is done, and I can rest.
This is all a bit too weird.
I don't know about that, but I do know they're waiting for you. Treat them well. They risked a lot to get you here.
Hello? Hello?
Eleanor!
Don't think she can hear you, my boy.
I just can't imagine my life without her.
It's often the way with those we love. We never really miss them until they're gone. All the more reason to value them whilst they're here.
Well, perhaps I should go in after her.
No, not a good idea at all. Remember what happened to those Italians.
Then.
I can't bear the suspense any longer. Tell me, what is the treasure that Brigante is really like?
It's the most amazing experience ever.
As you can see, our star exhibit has been returned here in its rightful place to our museum. But fame has been eclipsed by a new star exhibit. And another figure here is the person who is involved in the first discovery of finding the stone, Eleanor. Now, you found the stone, you recovered the stone, and it has been said that you are related to the people who first made the stone. How important do you think it is to the region?
Well, it's a real Meet the Ancestors evening tonight. It's begun to feel more like a family reunion than a public event.
And I gather, please correct me if I'm wrong, but you have actually met the Ancestor Queen and you've been in some kind of time travel miracle?
Yeah, I mean, I know it's easy to be sceptical, but it is true. It looks like the shape of our past is going to be clearer in the future.
You know, a long time ago, this staff was used by people who lived here.
Here?
Yes, right here. And they used it to make magic.
Magic?
Yes, real magic.
Well, they were ordinary people. Just like me and you. But they understood the mystical powers a lot more than we do. It seems that our world has lost touch with the magic of their world. It seems that this discovery might be telling us that we're not as clever as we might like to think we are.
Well, it looks like the debate will probably go on forever. In the meantime, it's back to the Manchester studio. Gordon.